So over the last couple of videos, I've showed you how to get yourself organized for the holidays, as well as how to not go over budget on holiday activities. But I thought about all the things that you do have to spend money on, like hosting a Friendsgiving or buying Christmas presents. Those are all things that are gonna cost money regardless of how much you research to save money on them. So in today's video, I'm gonna share with you my top three favorite money-saving apps that have literally saved me hundreds of dollars. I literally just added up how much they've saved me, and it is close to $850. I'm not kidding. So these are not my only money-saving apps, but they are my most frequently used, my favorite because of their ease of use, and obviously because of how much money they've made me. So since they saved me so much money / made me so much money, I wanted to make sure that you have them on hand right before you get your holiday shopping started. Now, if you're new to my channel, hi, welcome. My name is Lizbeth, and I make videos that help you plan for a better financial future while living your best life today. So if that's something that interests you, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so that you don't miss out on new weekly videos. So there are three apps that I'm going to go over with you, and there are three things that I want to make sure I cover with you about those apps. One being, what is it best used for, or what do I mainly use it for? Number two is, how do you use the app? And number three is, how do you earn the cash savings? The three apps that I'm going to cover for you are Rakuten, Ibotta, and Raise. Those are my favorite apps. Those are the ones that combined have earned me or saved me almost $850 in the time that I've had them. So needless to say that I am an avid fan of them. Now they all have kind of not very different purposes, but different purposes anyways, in that their forte are in specific kinds of stores. So to start off, I'm actually gonna go over Rakuten. And Rakuten used to be called Ebates, and I've mentioned them before as Ebates, but they've recently officially changed their name to Rakuten, but they're still pretty much the same thing as Ebates if you've had Ebates in the past. Now, Rakuten I mostly use for online purchases because it's super simple to use in the sense that it's a plugin on my computer. So anytime that I'm doing online shopping, it automatically tells me, hey, there can be this much cash back on the website that you're on. I simply click the button and I automatically receive any cash back if I go through and purchase any items. Now you can obviously go directly to Rakuten and then kind of see what stores they have there that are gonna give you cash back. And they have pretty much any store online. You can normally receive at least 1% cash back. They constantly run deals that can double or triple your cash back. So it's definitely a place that you wanna check out first to kind of see if the stores that you're planning on shopping are available, unless you have the plugin, in which case just go directly to wherever you're gonna shop on your computer and the plugin will tell you if they have any kind of cash back. There is an app for Rakuten, but they won't tell you, you know, it's not like a plugin that if you're on a certain app, it'll tell you, hey, by the way, there's a percentage cash back if you use Rakuten. That won't happen, so the app itself is not very useful. I still have it just to kind of reference it back to Ibotta or to Raise, but I don't tend to use the app as much as I do the website, which is why I recommend you having Rakuten for any online purchases and having the plugin on your computer to make things a lot smoother. Now, as far as how you earn your savings, you're going to get a percentage cash back based on whatever it tells you, right? And that gets added to your account. Now, Rakuten only sends out four different payments pretty much quarterly based on what you earned the last quarter. You have to have had earned at least $5 for them to send you a check or send you the $5 through PayPal. It has to be a minimum of $5. So for example, this past quarter, I didn't really do much online shopping, so I did not hit that $5 minimum threshold. I think I ended up about $4 or something. So it's not enough for them to cash me out and send me through PayPal because that's how I have it linked, but it'll roll over into this next quarter. Now that the holidays are here, I tend to do a lot more online shopping, especially during Black Friday. So more than likely by the end of next quarter, I would have hit that $5 threshold and I will get cashed out next quarter. And there you go. From PayPal, you can transfer it over to your account or use it directly from PayPal, however it is that you use PayPal money. So yeah, so when it comes to Rakuten, it's not immediate. You can't cash it out whenever you want. You do have to wait for that quarter to end and for them to send you the money via check or via PayPal. And they do have their quarterly schedule online, so you can always see when that last day of the quarter is going to be and when you're going to receive your cashback. Rakuten does have an option for in-store if you use the app, but when it comes to that, I prefer Raise. Now, Raise is a discounted gift card app. It's also a website, so you can go there. So what do I use Raise mostly for? I usually use Raise for in-store shopping. The idea of going to the app first and looking for a store to go shopping at doesn't really make a lot of sense. One of my favorite ways that I've used Raise lately is to purchase Regal Cinema gift cards through them before going to the actual movies. So we went to the movies last week, I believe. I knew that I was gonna have to buy tickets and maybe some popcorn and a drink. That's usually my standard. So that's about $25 or so. Now, Raise always has Regal Cinema gift cards for at least 5 to 10% off. So I purchased them through Raise. It's available pretty much right away. You might have to give it a couple of minutes. So I pay with that and I still get my Regal Cinema points as well. So I'm kind of double dipping in a sense where I'm getting a percent off right off the bat and I'm using my Regal Cinema app to get points on my ticket purchase. So one, I pay less for the tickets and I rack up points faster. So I'm getting kind of savings on both ends. So before I check out at any store, I make sure to go to Raise first and see if there's any discounted gift cards for that particular store. Now the thing is that sometimes you're at a store and something comes out to maybe $50, but there are only gift cards for $75 or $100. In this case, if it's a store that you don't normally go to, don't purchase the gift card. They usually have as little as $25. And if that's the case, if maybe it's either $25 or $75, but your total is $50, get the discounted gift card for the $25 and pay the difference. Because if you're not gonna go there often enough, it's not gonna be worth you paying for a $75 gift card if you're not gonna end up using it anytime soon. So just keep that in mind. It's always better to go for the lower gift card and just pay the difference than it is for you to pay more than you were already gonna pay for your purchases just to end up saving the card. There are only a couple of stores that I will actually keep the remaining balance on my wallet in Raise versus just paying the very minimum that I need to. Now, as far as your savings, you obviously earn it right then and there because you're purchasing a $25 gift card for the discounted rate of, 5% or whatever. So the discounts are pretty much automatic, which is great. Now, I've had Raise since 2015, and I've literally saved almost $300 in just buying their discounted gift cards whenever I'm at the store. Like I said, when it comes to Raise, I don't log on until I'm at the store, ready to pay, and then I can look up for additional savings there. I always make sure to pay with my credit card for Raise to make sure that I also get the cash back on my credit card as well. So my last favorite app is Ibotta. And I've actually mentioned this app in my How to Save on Groceries video, which I will link for you above, because for the longest time, it was all about getting cash back on grocery items that you shopped for. But now it's changed a little bit. It's gone from getting cash back on certain items that you get back to actually getting cash back on stores that you shop at and the entire balance. I literally just went to Joann's to pick up things that I needed for my daughter's Halloween costume, and I automatically got, I think it was 3% cash back for shopping at Joann's. And all I had to do was scan my receipt after I did the shopping. So not only did I use in-store coupons for Joann's, but I also got 3% cash back for just scanning my receipt, which I thought was a very sweet deal. So even though I've mentioned it when it comes to groceries, and it is still one of my favorite grocery shopping apps, this is a whole nother level because now we're getting to shop at regular stores and kind of seeing if they have any discounts or cash back on stores that you would normally shop at anyways. Versus Rakuten, this is more of in-store purchases. They also have online purchases and stuff like that, but I find it to be a lot easier when it comes to in-store purchases because you can pull up the app and see it right away. Another way that I've used Ibotta was it's kind of the same concept as Raise where you're getting a discount automatically. But for example, for Burlington, they had, I'm not sure how much it was, but I think it was 3%. And you're essentially buying a gift card for that amount of your purchase. So I think mine was like $55.30. And you buy a gift card for that amount through Ibotta. You pay with that gift card, so your gift card's now zero. But then Ibotta will give you a percentage back on that $55.30 that you spent. And they'll add it to your Ibotta account. So kind of similar to shopping through Rakuten because you're getting a percentage back on what you've spent, but this is actually shopping in the store and being able to get that percentage back. Now it gets added to your Ibotta account, and the way that you cash out your Ibotta account is first you have to make sure you have at least a $20 minimum, and then from there you can either trade it in for a gift card, which honestly I don't recommend because you can get discounted gift cards through Raise, so it doesn't seem worth it to me. But another way is for you to transfer it over to PayPal, which is what I do, and then you can use that cash and kind of do the whole process again, right? Get a discounted gift card and purchase things with that gift card. So I don't like cashing in my stuff for gift cards because I feel like if I can get the same amount in cash, then cash I can kind of stretch further than a gift card. So those are my three favorite cashback apps or cash savings apps and how I use them personally. Obviously, all of these three apps have multiple uses. So Ibotta not only has the coupons part where you can get cash back on certain items, they also have kind of the gift card thing, and then they have the cash back kind of like Rakuten does. So Rakuten also has that whole in-store cash back thing, but you have to have had linked the offer before you pay because it is connected to your card itself. So it just makes it a little bit more complicated because I have to go on there beforehand, but what if I'm not spending any money? Then it's just like extra work that was not necessary. Versus Ibotta, I can kind of look at once I have my cart full and determine if I'm going to go through their process of purchasing the gift card for that amount and then paying with it and getting the cash back that way. So that's why I prefer Rakuten for online purchases, Ibotta for in-store purchases, mainly grocery items if you go into the grocery store. And then Raise just kind of fits in there anywhere else that you might not get cash back, but you could possibly get a discounted gift card and still end up paying less than full price. So I definitely use these either interchangeably or sometimes in combination with each other to get me the most savings possible. So it's not to say that Rakuten can only be used online. They definitely have the other branches that you can maybe get a better deal that way. It just takes a little bit playing around with the apps and kind of if you're willing to go through the three apps when you're at the store to see which one's going to give you the best deal, you can do that. Sometimes I do that if I have extra time. But if I don't have the time, if I just want to get some kind of cash back, then I check really quickly which one's going to give me the best deal and just go with that one. So that way I'm not taking up too much time, but I'm also still saving money or getting some kind of cash back on the purchases that I'm already going to make. So for all of these apps, I do have referral codes. I get some kind of cash back if you choose to sign up with my referral code. Obviously, you don't have to. I still think you should get these apps, whether you use my referral code or not. They are very handy, especially with the holidays just around the corner. I want you to get as much cash back as you possibly can on all the money that you're going to be spending anyways. So if you want to use my referral code, go ahead, but you don't have to, but you should still definitely get the apps. Now, like I said, these are not the only apps I use. I have all those apps, but they don't tend to give you as much cash back or are not as easy to use as the apps that I've mentioned. I do have them, I do use them. And what I tend to do, especially with those little apps that are only gonna give me a certain amount back, I tend to just save them up throughout the year. And then come the holiday time, I can cash them in for the little amounts they are and add them to my holiday budget. I tend to do that with Ibotta too, because I can just rack it up and cash out at any point after the $20, which I normally do have around this time. So yeah, if you have any other apps that you use that save you money, whether it is in groceries or whether it is in regular shopping, please let me know in the comments below. I love trying out new apps. I'm not even kidding. My phone is full of them. So if you have one that you recommend, please let me know for myself and for others. If you have any other questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to leave me a comment down below or reach out to me directly through my Instagram or Facebook group. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. And that is all I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching. I will talk to y'all next time. Bye, guys.